Travis here with Chaparral Motorsports, and we're in the suspension department here at Precision Concepts. Robbie, can you just maybe tell us a little bit, don't get into too much detail and let out too many secrets, but just kind of give the consumer or the person watching this video what you guys have to offer when it comes to suspension, because I know a person can bring their bike into Chaparral, and if they have a fork seal out or something wrong with the suspension, we'll fix it. But we're not going to make it like Precision Concepts where it's race ready. You know, what do you have to say as far as what you guys have to offer for suspension?
Yeah, I mean, this is definitely one of the foundations of our company is our suspension department. And I mean, that we specialize in modifying the internals to customize the handling, the performance of each customer's suspension. I mean, suspension is one of the most subjective parts of a dirt bike, because you know, no one setting is going to handle perfect for everybody. Everybody's unique and different, rides the bike differently, so we specialize in setting each client's bike up specifically for them, their weight, riding style, their terrain, whether it's motocross, off-road, you know, rally riding, whatever they happen to prefer. And then I mean, and this is where the magic happens. I mean, it starts in Bob, in the founder's mind, in my dad's mind, and he comes up with the internal valving specs. And then John Snyder, and then he, you know, modify each customer's internals in their suspension. And then from there, I mean, we're a small shop with big ambitions. So it's just two guys. It's my dad and it's John in the suspension department. So, you know, our quality control is top notch. You know, it's only those two that are going to touch our customer's suspension. So we know everything that comes in here gets, you know, those two hands on it. So that's it.
When I get a new bike, some guys dig right into the motor. Some guys go directly to suspension. I want better handling right away. So I go to suspension first. What about you? Do you want more power at first? Can you handle stock suspension? Or are you like me?
I mean, with who my dad is, and just I've learned to appreciate and, you know, be able to ride a variety of suspension, but I definitely have my setup that I'm very comfortable on. But we also offer, you know, motor modifications and you know, ignition remapping, et cetera, just to dial in the whole package of every customer's motor. And in the chassis and motor department, you know, we have Phil Valdez. He's also our race team mechanic. Kind of like with the suspension department, every customer's bike that comes in here, Phil is, you know, he puts his hands on it. So we know that the again, the quality is first rate, because Phil's our in-house race team mechanic. So that same level of detail and professionalism goes to each client's bike. And I think that's what kind of sets us apart a little bit, is we know every client's bike that comes in here, who's touched it and what's work has been done on it.
So John does the suspension and Phil does the motors. Again, bring your bike down to Chaparral Motorsports. If your head gasket blows or something's wrong with the bearings or your valves, we'll fix it, no problem. But we're not going to make that motor race ready. We're not going to port the head, put in a good piston like that. Come down to Precision Concepts and they're going to do that for you. And it's going to be almost one-on-one. I mean, your motor's not getting passed around to multiple mechanics. Your forks aren't getting pushed to other guys around the shop. It's one dude that does the suspension and another one that does the motors.
Yeah, it's very hands-on and personalized experience from beginning to finish.
I mean, and you guys will work on any bike from a 65 all the way to a 650?
Absolutely, yeah. Any size bike and any type of discipline.
That's pretty rad. I have a Honda 450X myself, so if you guys see me down here rolling the bike out of my van, you know I'm going to be getting some suspension work done, because I love trail riding nowadays, and getting out to the open desert it's almost like a breath of fresh air, although you're doing 80 miles an hour. It's just so refreshing knowing that there's nothing else around you in the desert, and that's what you guys do when it comes to racing.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the thing, is our services, I mean, it's not just for the racer, it's for the enthusiast. I mean, everybody can benefit from having their bike dialed in, basically, and personalized to how they like the performance, whether it's the power delivery or especially the handling. I mean, you know, if you're out in the trails, you want to have absolute control and confidence in your bike, and that's what we specialize in.
So just like Chaparral, you guys love to see that customer come in after the fact and tell you how good it feels. So we have the same passion. I mean, competition's in our blood, but seeing that customer come through the door happy, loving what they do, and knowing that we've been a part of it, that's what we're all about. let's head on to the motor side, or you've got a couple more parts of this race shop. This isn't just it, right?
Yeah, exactly. We have the motor and chassis side in the back.
So let's get over there. Let's see some of the race bikes as far as what you guys do to those, and we'll get right back to you. So this is the race corner is what we're calling it. Essentially, this is where all the race bikes get built, and this is where Phil does his magic to the motors and to the chassis. Can you just explain this area? Because I got a ton of parts around me. I'm having a hard time concentrating right now, Robbie. Anytime I'm around race bikes, fresh tires, yeah, just anything like that. Just explain this little corner and what goes on.
Yeah, I mean, this is where Phil does all of our in-house work on the race bikes. We have Clay's bike right here, Blaine's right here. Seeds is on a bench over there getting worked on. So, but yeah, we have all of our spare parts on this side. These are the benches where all the work happens. And then, like you were saying, we got our tires and all of our spares. We have a lot of stuff that dates back into the like early teens as far as Kawasaki's, because we're, I mean, there's always something you can learn from a previous model. And, you know, if there's a part that you can test and try and can give you a performance advantage. So, you know, we have a lot of parts and accessories that we can, you know, pull from. But this is where all of the work happens.
So basically you guys take all the data and all the information throughout the year. And when you get the new bikes next year, you're able to use that information for the rider to meet their preferences.
Yeah, exactly. We have data dating back to 2009 as far as the Kawasaki's are concerned. And then, you know, we can dial in whether it's something we can use from them, information, you know, a certain part or something like that, to basically dial in the new models for each rider's preference, because everybody's subjective and might like something a little bit different.
Of course. I mean, we're all different shapes and sizes. We get on the gas in different areas of the corner. So that's really cool that you guys do that, because having data is really important when running a race team. What would you say is your longest ongoing brand, as far as who's been helping you out the longest when it comes to a sponsor?
I mean, as far as sponsors, we've had quite a few. I mean, Kawasaki's been with us since 2009, along with FMF. And you know, Maxxis has been with us for probably more than half a decade. So we have quite a few companies that have been backing our program, but everybody plays the role in helping our platform, helping give us the platform for success.
Speaking of FMF, we made a stop there, which you guys can see a video in our YouTube. We made a stop to FMF a couple months ago, and they are really rich into motocross racing as well, just like Chaparral and Precision Concepts. And they reach out to the off-road guys, and the pipes that they make offer a ton of performance, especially probably for these Kawasaki's.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, FMF has been a huge supporter of ours for almost a decade now. And I mean, the performance of their pipes is definitely an advantage for us in the off-road terrain. Especially that we like their power bomb just for the power delivery, because it's kind of a balance in the off-road side of our sport between durability and performance, and FMF offers the best of both.
You heard it from Robbie. So what would be the next step as far as when the bikes are built? Do you guys just take them straight to the race, or do you have a break-in period?
I mean, when we get a new model, it goes straight to the frame. So Phil splits the entire motor. We send the motor parts to Cryoheat, and Cryoheat has a process where they cryogenically freeze and then heat treat all of the internal parts, the moving parts, which helps add durability, takes away friction, so that adds performance. And then we get all of the products from each of our sponsors and build it from the ground up.
That's pretty impressive. So you guys don't even ride the brand new bike when it comes out of the box. Oh man. So there you have it. Thanks, Robbie. Thanks to everyone here at Precision Concepts. This place is pretty rad. If you guys want any performance suspension or motor modifications or anything done to your chassis and you ride off-road or motocross, come down to Precision Concepts. And keep an eye out for the team, Chaparral, Precision Concepts, Kawasaki. So thanks again, Robbie. You guys, if you want to see more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Give me a thumbs up while you're at it. I'm Travis with Chaparral Motorsports, and we'll see you guys next time.